This lecture is going to be about open and closed systems in energy, which work a little bit differently than open and closed systems in momentum. You'll remember from the momentum unit that a system is a group of objects, and we can choose objects to be in our system based on how the concept helps us solve problems. Because energy works differently than momentum, we're going to use systems in a slightly different way than we did with momentum. So basically, there's going to be a different rule for when something is an open and closed system, because there are different rules for when energy leaves a system as opposed to when momentum leaves a system. Before we go any further, we need to define mechanical energy and non-mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is any type of energy associated with the motion and position of an object that we can easily calculate and predict. So without even giving you the examples of mechanical energy here, I think that you could probably predict, based on that definition, that kinetic, gravitational potential, and elastic potential energy are the three types of mechanical energies. They're the only ones with very specific equations associated with them, and the types of energy associated with an object's motion and position. Non-mechanical energy is any type of energy that's not mechanical energy. All of these other types of energy do not depend on an object's position or movement, and they're a little bit harder to calculate and predict in general. Using this new definition, I can now say that a closed system in energy is a system where the only energy transfer and transformation that happens involves mechanical energy. And in a closed system, energy is not transferred to objects outside of the system. The total energy of the objects in the system stays the same. A very common example of a closed system in energy is something like a ball compressing a spring. So right now, because of the stretch of the spring, the ball has a certain amount of elastic potential energy. And it doesn't have any kinetic energy or potential energy. So the total energy of the ball is all elastic potential energy. All of that energy is stored in elastic potential, which is a type of mechanical energy. So the idea of a closed system in energy is that if the only transformation of this energy that happens is from one type of mechanical energy to another type of mechanical energy, that means that the total amount of energy in the system will remain the same even if the specific type of mechanical energy changes. As an example, we could let this ball go, and as it begins to move, the potential energy is lost and kinetic energy takes its place. So the elastic potential energy is being converted into kinetic energy. So it can roll like that for a little while, and you'll notice that now all of its energy is kinetic energy, and that's the same amount of energy as it had when it was compressed into the spring. It's just that before, that mechanical energy existed in the spring, and now it exists in the object itself, but it's the same total energy. And then if it starts to go up a hill, it's going to rise to a certain height, and as it rises its height, it's going to lose kinetic energy and gain potential energy. But again, the idea is that if just a transformation of mechanical energy is happening, that means that the total energy in the system is going to remain the same. The energy is not actually leaving that ball, it's just being transformed from kinetic energy to potential energy. And when it gets to the top, all of its energy is potential because it's come to a stop, so it doesn't have any kinetic left. And because the total energy of the ball remains the same, even in reverse, we know that if we drop the ball from the same height that it rose to in the first situation, it will actually compress the spring to the exact same length that it compressed the spring in the other situation because the total energy is remaining the same. So the total gravitational potential at the beginning will equal the total elastic potential at the end. Another example of a closed system is when mechanical energy is transferred from one object to another. For example, if we have a perfectly elastic collision between two identical spheres, you can see that one is just giving the other its kinetic energy, but the total amount of kinetic energy between them is remaining the same. This is actually true for all elastic collisions. An open system in energy is a system where energy is transformed from mechanical to non-mechanical energy, or vice versa, or mechanical energy is transferred from or to an object outside the system, and the total energy in the system changes. So just like in momentum, in an open system, the total momentum changes. Here in energy, in an open system, the total energy in the system changes, but the reasons for that are different. An example of an open system could be mechanical energy being lost to heat due to friction. Friction on the ground actually performs the function of transforming kinetic energy into heat energy. So as this box slides across the floor, the friction that it experiences generates heat energy, which is really coming from its kinetic energy. So after it slides, some of that energy is no longer in the box and can't be retrieved by the box. It's in the air and in the ground as heat because of friction. So that energy was lost from that system. It wasn't destroyed because energy cannot be created or destroyed. It just no longer exists in the box and it can't be easily retrieved. Now that the heat is in the air, it's just going to be lost to the atmosphere as a whole. Another example of an open energy system is whenever you hit the gas on your car. There, non-mechanical energy is transformed into mechanical energy. So this car starts with no kinetic energy and no mechanical energy in general, but as you hit the gas, it begins to get more and more kinetic energy. So that's an example of a change in the mechanical energy of a system, so we would say that that's an open system. And that energy still has to come from somewhere, it can't be created or destroyed. Here specifically, that energy is coming from the chemical energy in the gas in the car. So you can gain as much kinetic as you lose in chemical energy. So that's the basic idea of an open and closed system with energy. The big idea of this unit is that energy cannot be created or destroyed, which is going to help us solve problems with it.